suspended. Furthermore, the two airfields on Iwo Jima were being used as a base for Japanese fighter planes to attack American planes. On February 19, 1945, the 4th and 5th Marine Divisions landed on Iwo Jima. Before their arrival, U.S. forces had bombarded the island with shells and bombs for more than 70 days. The Japanese were well entrenched. Months before the arrival of U.S. forces, the Japanese commander on Iwo Jima, General Tadamichi Kurabayashi, has ordered his engineers to expand the island's caves and build an intricate system of connecting caves and tunnels that hit Japanese gun positions all over the island. The Japanese soldiers burrowed into hiding places were invisible to American Marines landing on the island on February 19. At first, the Marines met almost no resistance. It was not until they had made their way well inside the nest of hidden enemy that the Japanese opened fire from caves and disguised pillboxes. The barrage of deadly fire cut Marines in half. Surviving Marines scrambled to take cover but found it impossible to dig into the island's volcanic ash. Along with bullets, survivors were assaulted by the sickening smell of sulfur and decaying bodies. To break the impasse, flamethrowers brought in to burn the unseen enemy. From the heights of Mount Suribachi, hidden Japanese guns, rake machine gun, and artillery fire on the Marines. The ancient volcano, the highest part on the island, was eventually captured by the Leathernecks on February 23. Associated Press photographer Joe Wiesenfeld snapped his famous picture of five Marines and one Navy corpsman raising the American flag at the top of Mount Suribachi. However, the Marines still had to capture the island's two airfields. Before the island was taken, three of the flag raisers would die. Admiral Nimitz declared a victory on March 14, but the last pocket of enemy resistance was not clear from the